I was hospitalized multiple times for pancreatitis, at which time they decided they were going to put a stent in order to fix the pancreas problems. When they put the stent in, I was still in extreme pain. So they went in to look at the stent, and when they did that, they used gadolinium as part of an MRI procedure. I was told nothing about the gadolinium. I did not give any permission. I wasn't asked if I could use the dye or anything. They put the dye in, and as soon as it was injected into my veins, my body lit on fire. And from that point forward, things went wrong. I'd already had the dye in my vein, so I didn't push the button to get out of the MRI machine. So I finished the MRI, and when I got out, I said, I'm in terrible pain. And they said, don't worry, just drink a lot of water, go home, in 24 to 48 hours, it will all be out of your system. And I was so distraught that I even went back to her after I got dressed, and I said, can you just look at my back and tell me, is it bright red, and is there a rash there? Because it's hurt so bad. And she said, I don't see anything, just drink a lot of water. I went home, a couple days, I drank a lot of water, and the pain subsided for a couple days. But then it came back with a vengeance that burned so bad from my esophagus to my bowel that I describe it as being a chicken that was pulled out of the deep fat fryer and is still sizzling, because every pore in my body was just sizzling and hot and burning. I couldn't sleep. I couldn't eat. I didn't eat for 2.5 months. I lost 40 pounds. Because I couldn't eat. I drank Gatorade, Ensure, and Jell-O. That was what I ate and drank. So every time I would go to the doctor, every doctor would say, well, we don't know why you're in pain. We fixed your pancreas, so let's give you some pain medicine, and we're going to send you to a pain specialist. And when I said to them, well, could it be the dye that you put in for the MRI? And they said, no, that's not it. And I was like, well, are you sure? And they're like, no, that gets out of your system in 24 to 48 hours. I just researched on my computer everything possible. And that's when I found the Chuck Norris story and that his wife had been poisoned with gadolinium. And then I called my doctor immediately. I said, we need to do a 24-hour gadolinium urine test. He said, no. I said, I'll send you some articles and you can rethink this. When the results came back, they were positive for gadolinium and they were high. Higher than anyone I had ever heard of, which was concerning to me, but based on the burning I was having, it made sense. At least I knew. The doctor, when I went to get the report, he handed me the report. He said, I don't know what to do to help you. I don't know how to help you, who to send you to, or what to do next. So I'm going to excuse myself and wish you the best of luck. And he walked out the door. He handed me a piece of paper from the Mayo Clinic that said my number was 8.4, which was high, very high. Gadolinium should not be in the human body, and so you would never have a number. It would be at zero. He handed me the paper. He said, I don't know how to help you. I don't know who to send you to for help, and I don't know what to do next. So I'm going to excuse myself. And he was my doctor for 22 years. Excused himself, and he walked out the door. As he walked out the door, I stopped him, and I said, what's the next step? He turned to me, and he said, there are no next steps. I'll be happy to write you a referral to the Mayo Clinic if that's what you decide. And by the way, drink a lot of water. And he walked out the door. I decided to do chelation. Chelation's the only way to get it out of the body. It's the only known way to do it. There's a couple different chelations, but I chose DTPA with calcium and zinc. It's a two-day process. The process, first day is with calcium, second day is with zinc, and then you excrete it through your kidneys, and the number should go low. The baseline number will blow up by as high as 60 times the number. Mine went to 99. So my number for my first chelation showed that I was at 99, which is just exorbitant. I know a lot of GAD people from the support sites. Most of them are like 30 at the worst case. So I knew I was in trouble. It's changed my life. It's changed my DNA. It's changed who I am. I'm not the person that my husband married 25 years ago. It's hard on our marriage. I am consumed by it. I want to make a difference. I really want this drug off the market or highly regulated and used only in specialized cases that were life-threatening. This is a long road to hoe, and I am fighting for my life. Every time I have a chelation, I have new symptoms. My urine has blood in it. It has protein in it that's not supposed to be there. All of the fibers, all of the nerve endings in my urethra have been burned so badly that it's on fire, and to pee hurts all the time. It's in my bones. My bones are full of ache, and it's so deep inside the bones. But gadolinium competes with calcium. So everywhere you have calcium in your body, the gadolinium is now taking over the calcium. So our bones have calcium in them. So that's like a problem. So every time I go to the doctor, I come up with new symptoms every time I have a chelation. I've had calcium deposits removed from my tendons. And why they grew there, no one knows. There's so much unknown stuff about gadolinium, and science is trying to come up with reasons for all these symptoms, but no one really knows. The only thing that we do know is that the manufacturers, all four manufacturers that manufacture nine gadolinium products, came out and said in a statement that it is retained in your brain, in your bones, in your tissue, and in your organs. And it can be retained for weeks, months, years. It's unknown because only time will tell. Doctors have said, and researchers have said, that to get the gadolinium out of your system would take up to like 178 years. It's not going to happen. We don't live that long. I'm 60 years old. Where do we go from here? The number started at 99. I've had four treatments, and my number's at 48 as of the beginning of this treatment. So it is getting lower, but with every treatment, I get new symptoms, and I don't feel any better. I don't feel better. The pain levels are so high. My pain levels are at a 7 on a good day, and on most days, a 9. On the days that are 9, I don't leave my house for 2 or 3 days at a time. Days that are at a 7, I get out of bed, I walk my dog, I try to be myself, I put a smile on, I go forward, because I was raised that you have a choice to be happy about life. But this is nothing to be happy about. Nothing. I am fighting for my life. Out of 30 million people that got MRIs, a third got injected with this dye. It's ruthless. It's ruthless. Gadolinium is used in MRIs to enhance the image so that the radiologist can read it better. It makes the image of the tissues and the blood vessels brighter. Think of it as a glow-in-the-dark tool. How does that help patients, especially if they have a reaction like I had, and now we're fighting for our lives? It's not helpful. Other countries have removed it from the market. Not all of them, but they've removed a lot of the linear dyes, which I was injected with. They're not used in Europe, the UK, Japan, and several other countries. The FDA in the United States chose not to take it off the market. They chose to continue to use it. Why? Because it's a huge money maker. Billions of dollars. Billions of dollars. When you're in the machine and you have been injected with gadolinium, it's traveling to the places where your system has been compromised. All my insides are burned, and now I have small fiber neuropathy because it burned all the small fibers, because that's where the gadolinium went to, because that's what they were trying to look at. So the gadolinium's there, it's inflamed from the pancreas being inflamed, and the metal is traveling there so that they can see a better image and light it up. I would have liked to have been part of the conversation about what was going to happen to my body. Gadolinium damages your body, all the organs, all the tissue, everything. So for me, because I'd had shoulder issues, it went to the shoulder. So now I have deep bone pain in my shoulders. Nothing will take the pain away from the shoulders. I have burnt all of the small fibers in everywhere in my body. And the small fiber tissue is the most sensitive tissue that we as human beings have in our body. It's all been burned. So I burn from here to here. I have neurogenic bladder, which I mentioned, and I have lost my tooth. My tooth. It killed the bone in my tooth because it goes after the calcium. So the calcium, it burned the tooth. So now this tooth, to replace it, is over $6,000. $6,000. Who has that kind of money laying around? So I just want you not to have gadolinium. I don't want you to have contrast. I want it to be highly regulated and only used in certain cases. I sleep in a chair because every pore in my body is on fire and burning so badly that sleeping in a bed with covers on touching my skin hurts so bad. So I sleep in a reclining chair that's designed to take the weight off of the shoulders and the hips so that I can get some sleep. So as part of the treatment program, the doctor who said he couldn't help me anymore said, he says, you have fibromyalgia. I'm pretty sure you have fibromyalgia. And he said, let's put you on gabapentin, which is a drug that they use for nerve pain. Gabapentin didn't touch it. And I kept saying to him, it doesn't touch it. It's not helping the pain at all. So instead of taking me off that drug and putting me on a different drug, he said, well, let's raise the dose. And I'm like, raising the dose isn't going to help. But I went along because we're taught to trust our doctors. But after months, I went on strike. I said, I'm not doing this anymore. I'm going off all the drugs. I'm currently on one pain medicine, and that's it, other than I use CBD. CBD is a good for pain, and I can take it internally and externally. One of the frustrating things about this whole thing is when I went back to the doctor who had been my doctor forever, he's like listed it as fibromyalgia on my chart. He can't even literally say the word gadolinium. He won't say the word out loud to me, but he says, how's your fibromyalgia? How's the pain for your fibromyalgia? I keep saying, I don't have fibromyalgia. Maybe I do, but if I do, it's because it was induced after I was injected with gadolinium, and we're just not connecting the dots and we're not speaking our truth, and the doctors aren't speaking the truth. And maybe that's because they're afraid of lawsuits and too many other things, but you're destroying people's lives. And I was told, well, the doctors did a favor for you because by diagnosing you with fibromyalgia, then they can order pain medicines and things to treat you that your insurance will pay for, where nothing is covered. No insurance covers gadolinium, even though the medical industry created this nightmare. As I continue to work with my doctor, he tells me I have fibromyalgia, and he's treating me for fibromyalgia. He says that he can treat me with drugs that will help the pain. And because I listed as fibromyalgia, the insurance will cover it and all of that. That all makes sense, except for that I don't have fibromyalgia and I have gadolinium poisoning. Gadolinium deposition disease. Let's call it what it is. Insurance doesn't pay for chelation, and it's thousands of dollars. And I travel 9 hours with airfare and hotel and restaurants that I wouldn't otherwise do, and I'm away from my family for weeks at a time. So it's wrong. It's just wrong. And so I quit taking the fibromyalgia medicine. I told my doctor I'm not doing this anymore, and I started seeking other places, naturopaths, more doctors who would listen, somebody who knew about gadolinium. I was lucky to find the doctor in the town where I do chelation because they understand it. They admit it, that it's wrong and that the industry's done us wrong. And they're working to figure it out. But at least they're partnering with us, which at least makes you feel human and not crazy, because we're not crazy. We're not crazy people. This is a medical-induced disaster, ruining lives. People need to understand lives are ruined. And a doctor at the FDA even went on file when they voted to do the black box warning and change the warning for people. She even went on file. One person on the FDA panel said, the literature that we're changing isn't strong enough. The new black box warning says patients should receive. Well, should is a pretty dicey word. Doesn't mean you're going to, but you should get a medication guidebook so that you have a choice and you know what they're going to inject you with. It's going to be your choice. It's your body. Get educated. Ask questions. Don't let anyone put anything into your body unless you know what it is and you know the repercussions. Don't believe them at face value. Those are lab techs who don't even have training like the neurologist. The neurologist is nowhere when you get your MRI, not usually. And so you're listening to a tech who's making minimum wage probably at a hospital. It's not fair. Don't put gadolinium in your body. Don't do it. It ruins lives. There's no cure. There's no antidote. There's nothing to fix this. Once it's in your body, it's in there. Even with chelation, you're getting it out a little at a time, but you're also stirring it up in your body. So it's soaking in and absorbing in new places that it wasn't before. And now you're just spreading it around if it's not being excreted. You have new places, and then you'll have new pains, and you'll have new symptoms. And then what? Life has changed so much for me. I didn't even tell you that my brain fog is so bad that I've driven my dog to the park hundreds of times. I can't find my way to the park, and I can't find my way home from the park. So I'm not able to take my dog to the park. How simple is that? I get to places I've lived in the same town for my entire life, and I'm lost. I can't remember things. The brain fog, the memory, it's gone. Things that I should be able to recall, vacations, I don't even remember being there. My husband's like, well, why do I take you on vacation? You don't remember it anyways. Let's just watch TV and you can travel on TV. I'm like, no. The gadolinium also increases anxiety. You're afraid to go out. You're afraid to be around your friends. You're afraid to accept things because you don't feel good. So you cancel a lot. You stay indoors, you hibernate, you become more isolated, which can cause depression, can cause a lot of other things. I'm not even 60 years old. It shouldn't be this way. Gadolinium destroys relationships. 40-year friendships have had to go on hold or become boundary-driven and can't just free flow in the loving friendships that we've had because gadolinium has taken over my life. It's consuming me. And my friends are tired of hearing about it. And worse, when you go out to dinner or you see someone, they tell you, you look great. I haven't seen you look this good in years. And I think to myself, well, then I'm fooling everyone, so I'm doing my job just right. It's cost me friendships. My husband, he's so sick of hearing about gadolinium. He rolls over in the morning. I have my tablet going. I'm reading the newest research that was released from Europe from the night before, or from a doctor who posted late in the day and made a Twitter and some new announcement. I'm consumed with gadolinium, trying to figure out, how are we going to fix this? When is the antidote coming? How soon are they going to name the disease so it can be covered by insurance? It's life-consuming. My husband, he's like, our relationship has changed. We used to be inseparable. We used to do everything together. And now we hardly are even in the same room most of the time because, unfortunately, he loves me. He wants me to be healthy. It's destroying him watching me suffer so much. He doesn't know how to fix me, and he's a protector, and he wants it to be fine, and it can't be fine. What do you do? A lot of people just want to die. I'm not going to give up. I'm going to make a difference. I'm going to be an advocate. I'm going to drive change. And that's why I'm doing this film. That's why I'm telling my story. People are going to Congress. I'm going to go to Congress. I'm going to go to some of the seminars that they're teaching the new radiologists and telling them MRI safety includes that it's okay to use gadolinium. I want them to meet me. I want them to hear my story. It's not okay. And you're changing people's lives for the worst. You're ruining people's lives. I actually have one group of friends who came to my house when I was doing my research, and they said, I really think you're just under a lot of stress. Maybe you have irritable bowel syndrome, or you have a hernia in your stomach or something, and that's what's causing all this pain. I really don't think it's gadolinium, Debbie. You look fine. You look better than you've ever looked. So maybe you just need to decompress and not think about it so much and not be so stressed out. Those were some of my better friends. I don't see those people anymore. I miss them. But they didn't get it. So I get it. I get it that that's their truth. That's not my truth. My story, my life is based on truth. And the truth is, gadolinium kills. The pain from this is horrific. Every single day, 24 hours a day, pain, excruciating pain beyond comprehension. I'm sorry, no one can comprehend this pain. It's horrible. I don't sleep. I don't eat. And being an advocate against gadolinium, I have to say part of what concerns me about all of this is there's so many people out there who've had MRIs with contrast and have been diagnosed with other things like fibromyalgia. Those are conveniences for the medical profession. And people trust their doctors, so they believe them when they're told they have fibromyalgia or some other disease. Get educated. Ask questions. It's your body. Do not let them put chemicals in your body that will destroy your life. I'm in pain every single day. I didn't even talk about the antidepressants that the doctors have put me on, because antidepressants sometimes help with pain. And as part of the pain management, they put me on antidepressants. One antidepressant I took it one pill one night. I woke up the next day and my goal for the whole day was to commit suicide. I was on a mission and I knew I had enough drugs in my arsenal to do it. So I was going to go to the cabin and do it. Thank God that one pill wore off in like 36 hours and I was back to being common sense me to make a decision that was a fucked up decision. I don't do drugs anymore. I don't do the medical profession. I'm done. I'm done with the medical profession. I knew it was wrong. I knew that I wasn't right. And I knew I was off. And my husband picked up on it. And thank God he did, because he probably saved my life.
If you or a loved one have been harmed by gadolinium, first, I'm so sorry. But second of all, email MRIGadoliniumDisease@gmail.com. Your email will go to Dr. Regina Sutton, who is currently looking for people's information so that she can get us approved with an actual medical diagnosis, which could potentially help a lot of people. Also, you can report your case to the FDA. We need the power in numbers to show that this is happening to people everywhere. And lastly, you can join our Facebook groups or social media. If you have not been harmed by GAD, consider yourself lucky and run the other way. I'm just kidding. We actually need your help. So there's a drug that can potentially chelate gadolinium, but believe it or not, it's not publicly available. Weird how that works, isn't it? The antidote is not available. Another thing is we really want to see gadolinium deposition disease on consent forms. As of right now, people are not told that there is an issue with taking gadolinium unless they have kidney disease, and that is just outright wrong. So call up your local congressperson and tell them, hey look, I've noticed some of my friends have been getting poisoned. Is there anything we can do about that? And mention these two things to them. We need funding for HOPO, the drug that can potentially chelate gadolinium, and we need informed consent, because it's not really enough to just put it in small print on a medication guide that no patient receives. It's not enough to do that. Who's going to be able to see it if you're not giving them the medication guides? We need GDD put on consent forms. When people sign for MRIs, tell them what is possible. Thank you for watching, and come back again.